こんばんは。私はジャスカと申します。私はダンスが大好きです。それから出身はソニュラスです。どうぞよろしく。
In Audre Lord's book, Sister Outsider, she said, "I have come to believe over and over again that what is most important to me must be spoken, made verbal, shared, even at the risk of having it bruised or misunderstood. To me specifically, as a Palawan and African-American woman, I'm understanding now that I have a unique perspective. And oftentimes, if not all the time, even at 22 years old, I have yet to find where I belong. In every sphere I've been in, people have made it clear to me that I just don't belong. So, I'm creating my own, and for those who wish to be included." Lord also said, "Your silence will not protect you." Now that I reflect back to some aspects of my life, I'm upset that I did not speak up enough, or to do more to defend myself. I guess it's because I didn't know how to. My family's cultural values didn't give me the freedom to say how I felt. Every time I did speak up, it was seen as being disrespectful. So I just stopped talking. The more I stopped talking, I began developing a fear for confrontation. And at the same time, I contributed to the work to those of my oppressors. I doubted my own thoughts and capabilities as a woman. But anything that is learned can be unlearned. And I am acknowledging this fear and using it as a source for my own strength.
It's been a while, but I come around.
In my family, I have a Caucasian father, a Palawan mother, a developmentally disabled younger brother, a Caucasian and Palawan younger sister, and an older Black lesbian sister from Mabin, Mississippi. Like any other 90s baby, I grew up watching That's So Raven, All That, The Proud Family, you name it. Every show that had a dance scene, I made sure I learned the choreo. Dance was always a part of my life, and it wasn't until my freshman year at North High I realized dance was something I wanted in my life forever. Choreology was just the beginning. That taught me it's okay to make mistakes, the value of sacrifice and perseverance. Choreology was my family. I met so many talented individuals on this team that pushed me to work hard for what I want. Self-made, self-taught, self-determined, choreology was a foundation to stay driven, passionate, and humble. Because growing up in the 831, it was either get out or get buried. Even after choreology ended, I was determined to continue my growth as a dancer. It wasn't long before I auditioned for an adult team in the Bay Area called Syndicate. This team opened my eyes to new ways of dancing, but more importantly, it showed me the need for a good role model. My mentees, Ben and Joanna, are also reasons why I continue to persevere, no matter what I may face. Syndicate provided me with tools that really helped me communicate without using words. But I'm learning now, through Black Feminist Thought, that I must incorporate both words and actions.
Exactly. Briefly, can you describe our friendship and the influence I had when I was on Syndicate? You know, if you think I had any, any of that sort.
I feel like our friendship is very fun, like nothing but good vibes. The influence that you brought on Syndicate is again fun, but although you are fun, you also know how to like get down to business when it's time, and I truly, that's very inspiring.
So second question, from a choreographer standpoint, can you describe what kind of attributes I had as a dancer that made you want to work with me? Essentially like anything you observed, like attitude, again, you already mentioned like work ethic, mm-hmm. anything of that sort.
Definitely attitude, definitely performance. Your performance is like something that was very spot on for most of my pieces. Also, your work ethic is very, I felt like I took that into consideration. I knew you would definitely, whatever I throw at you, you would get down. And I honestly just love the way your body moves. It, like, everything fits perfectly for what my choreo brings. Or what you, how did I say this? My choreo. You make my choreo work. Pretty much, yeah.
sort of an overlap, but why did you choose me to be the focus of attention for your down and knee?
Pretty much what I said before. You were perfect for the role.
So how did I fulfill the role or vision that you wanted to convey to the audience, judges, community? Like, was there a specific message that you were trying to send out? Right. Were you even thinking of a message?
I wasn't really thinking of a message per se. I wasn't trying to get out a message or anything, but pretty much because of whenever I walk a piece, whoever does it the best in my opinion, which obviously counts because I'm the choreographer, is a person who I just want, okay, like that person's obviously gonna be center of my piece and they're obviously gonna kill it. So I guess that's the message I wanna go. It's like, look at this person kill my choreography.
Yeah. Do you feel that you have created an environment where your dancers feel comfortable enough to speak up or speak out against anything that defies their beliefs? Or like, you know, in any situation, even if it's not just mine, just your experiences of your own, have you been in an environment where like, maybe like the choreographer or like directors be like, that kind of give that message, like it's okay to speak up and speak, like, or just anything, like, if you don't feel comfortable doing this, like, you don't have to. Like, yeah. You know, like, do your dancers, like, understand, like, if they really don't want to do something, they don't have to? Mm-hmm. Like, do you feel like this is fed to our dancers, or, like, in the community as a whole, or is it more like, whatever you're told to do, you do?
Like, whatever we do is not because we want to make you feel uncomfortable at all. It's purely dance, and it's for the picture, and for this, message that we're trying to say to like the audience and stuff. So it wasn't really like, I didn't want to do it just to like stir the pot, you know?
Yeah.
I'm sorry if I made you feel uncomfortable, because that's definitely not what I wanted to do. But I'm glad you did speak up about it. But I'm glad we did have that moment where we could say, like, you know, like, whenever things like this happen, it's just because it's just dance. I do feel like there are moments where dancers don't feel comfortable speaking up, saying they don't want to do a certain thing. And I honestly don't know if that's, like, I mean, I guess it is bad, in a sense. But then I'm also thinking about it in like just an art like type of view,
yeah,
like it is just dance.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know, I'm kind of like back and forth.
So this is like a gray area, you would?
Yeah.
Honestly,
kind of is.
This is one of those gray areas, and that's how I also took it as well.
Yeah.
Like, it is a gray area, like, if a dancer approached you with concerns about choreography making them feel uncomfortable, what would you have done to make them feel?
Depending on what it is, and I don't think I would ever go to like the extreme, like, I don't know, like people making out with each other and stuff, I would never do that. Unless it's like that, then I would tell them that it's just dance. And I want to do this just to get this image in my mind that I want to like, or this picture in my mind that I would like to show the audience or the judges and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just not serious, it's just dance, yeah.
Oh, do you think that there's a difference between objectifying versus like celebrating women's bodies?
Yes, I think there is like a difference, because there are like, you know, like the girls' pieces, I feel like that's like celebrating like how women move. Mm-hmm. And it's amazing. Yeah. Sorry, I don't
know. No, it's okay. No, honestly, it's very nice. And this is like a constant tug and pull. Like, I don't mean to put you on spot or like attack you in any type of way. Like, this is a general, like, sort of like understanding, because like, this is why, kind of why I'm asking, like, is it really like the dancers, or is it like the influence? Like, sort of, I'm kind of getting at like the influence of like hip hop. Like, hip hop holds
music,
a lot of
these.
Yeah, exactly. Like, you see it constantly, and like, it's become normalized. It is something that I feel like we don't really, or at least I didn't at the time, like, really look at it in that way.
Yeah.
Like, I just knew in that moment, like, I felt uncomfortable, but like, I was just like, well, it is art, like, it's dance. This is me just being like portraying, like, sticking to the role that was given to me.
Honestly,
like, that's how I was thinking of it at that time. And now that I'm in like this Black Feminist Thought course, that I'm really starting to engage in these, and I'm just sort of wondering, like, I wonder if like the audience really takes it in as that, or has it just become like,
I feel like, they don't.
Like blinders, like, we just see it all the time. Like, when you see a badass, you just want to smack it. And it's just like one of those things. And that's something, a message that we should be very careful if that's what we're sending. If, like, you know, in general, like, with anything.
Because
at the end of the day, these are women's bodies, these are women. We are also people, or human beings, not just things for men to just grab on. Like,
That's so true. That's so true. And I'm so happy that you're opening my eyes to this, because it is one of those things where it's just like, okay, like, I've been seeing this since I was like small. Like, why? I watch music videos all the time, and they always have girls dancing. Guys like feeling them up, and the girls just accepting it and taking it. So I guess that really is just what.
And then it just goes back to like societal views of women, like how we treat women, and you know, it's just unfortunate sometimes. And even as a Black woman, like, it's, I can admit it's pretty hard, but that's why I'm fighting with power.
I'm so happy about that.
Thank you again for being in my video, and just giving like this insight. Like, this is a dialogue that needs to happen, and just again, thank you.
Yeah, you even come to me.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We're good.
Cool. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. If we ever dance together, I'm never going to have a tattoo again.
No, it's cool.
All right.
We teach girls shame. Close your legs. Cover yourself. We make them feel as though by being born female, they're already guilty of something. And so, girls grow up to be women who cannot say they have desire. They grow up to be women who silence themselves. They grow up to be women who cannot say what they truly think. And they grow up, and this is the worst thing we do to girls, they grow up to be women who have turned pretense into an art form.
It's been a while, but I come around, let you know what's up now. No album late, my money's kinda up now. Still been taking care of my mama. Disappeared from the scene, left my old team. Had to find a new approach to an old dream. And that's not to take a shot at my old team. I just want you to see, this is me. For who I am, please accept me for what I do. I'm just doing everything that I can, 'cause all I wanna be, I wanna be true, yeah. And all I wanna be is true. Alright, alright. I look up to the sky, Lord, why do I cry when no one is looking? Is the blame for this pain even caused by the shame of this fame I've been given? But my pride don't cause me to hide my feelings, 'cause I can only be real,
be real. Oh, oh.
One.
I'm glad you heard. Now, when I come to a photo shoot, let it be of quality. You know why? Because I put quality in what I do. I spend time and I spend energy and I spend effort and I spend everything I have, every fiber of my being to give people quality. When I am assertive, I'm a bitch. When a man is assertive, he's a boss.
Bossed up.
He bossed up.
Yeah, he bossed up.
No negative connotation behind bossed up, but lots of negative connotation behind being a bitch.
Bitches ain't shit but hoes and tricks. Bitches ain't shit but hoes and tricks.
Quit calling a bitch! You.
Every time I hear a brother call a girl a bitch or a hoe, trying to make a sister feel low, you know all of that got to go. Now everybody knows there's exceptions to this rule. I don't be getting mad when we playing, it's cool. But don't you be calling me out my name. I bring crap to those who disrespect me like a dame. That's why I'm talking. One day I was walking down a block, I had my cut off shorts on, right? Cause it was crazy hot. I walked past these dudes when they passed me. One of them felt my booty, he was nasty. Yeah. I turned around red, somebody was catching the rat. Then the little one said,
yeah, me bitch.
And laughed. Since he was with his boys, he tried to break fly. I punched him dead in his eyes.
Who you calling a bitch?
U-N-I-G-Y.
So, what does Black feminist thought mean to me? Black feminist thought is a state of mind, a combination of self-belief, self-empowerment, and activism in a fight for social justice. Black feminist thought is an atmosphere that allows my experiences to stimulate a Black feminist consciousness. Whether it's in a studio, in a classroom, or behind a camera, Black feminist thought requires me to forge my own self-definitions, creating another lane within the world of dance to reject negative images of Black womanhood, and building more true images of what a Black woman could be. And I am a Palawan and African American woman provoking Black feminist thoughts.